It's Sunday, the 4th of December, 2016. Here I am, back from church in my new shirt. Do you like this? Oh, yeah. It's almost Christmassy, but not quite. No Christmas decorations until a minimum of 2 weeks before Christmas. Yes. Look, can you see a Christmas decoration here? No, this is just my normal revolving ball and my new shirt. Did you like this? I bought another couple of shirts off Amazon. £33. This is, I think that's very nice. I believe this is a paisley shirt. Oh, it might sell in the packet. I mean, just a minute. Oh, no, it doesn't say. It just says floral. F-L-R-L. Floral, maybe? Floral, something like that. I'm so glad that they've stopped. Do you like it? I'm very pleased with this. I've got another one which I'll be wearing tomorrow. More of a mauve colour. Yes. Oh, you're over there, aren't you? I've turned the little hole on the camera around, so you're that side today instead of that side. Don't know why I did it. I thought it might make a change, but it's completely confused me. So I think you're over there, but you're not. You're over there, aren't you? Not there, not there, 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 and there. Yes. I'm so glad that they've stopped putting little pins to hold shirts on. Do you remember they used to do that all the time? Oh, you're there, aren't you? I might have to turn it round again. I can't cope with this. Do you remember they used to stick little pins in all the time? Instead, they use these things. Now, look. Oh, bless me, Father, for I have sinned. Since last night, I have had one box of those. Oh, I've done it again. These are so delicious. So on the way home last night, once again, the motorway's closed. OK, so I've diverted onto the A30, which goes past two petrol garages. There's a Gulf, which sometimes has his petrol on sale for £1.10.9 a litre, which is the cheapest around here. And there's a BP garage, but I don't fill up at the BP garage. That tends to be the most expensive one. But they do sell these. Oh, yum, yum, yum. Marks, these are actually, they've got like a Marks and Spencer's attached to the BP garage. And look at the Marks and Spencer, extremely chocolatey round chocolate biscuits. More than 60% chocolate. Yum, yum. I wonder how many calories in here. 1 minute. I haven't got my glasses with me today. They're downstairs. Let's have a look here. Will it say per biscuit or something? Oh, it doesn't say. Oh, well, if it doesn't say, there can't be any calories in there, can there? Does it? Oh, yes, it does. Per biscuit. Oh, you can't be serious. 115 calories a biscuit. How many in there? it doesn't say. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's about 1,000 calories I've had since last night. Isn't that terrible? And I had two. Well, it's not, I didn't do too bad. I had two when I got in. And I've just had the rest now. Very, very tasty and highly recommended. Oh, yes. Now, talking of Amazon, which is where this shirt came from, and tomorrow's shirt, stay tuned tomorrow, boys and girls, another new shirt for you to view. £33. This would make a lovely Christmas present, I think. 33 quid for one of those. It's quite thick cotton. Never ever buy polyester in a shirt or sheets. Please don't buy polyester. You will regret it. I've just realised. I thought that would look. I've. Thank you. I haven't taken my cardboard out. I thought that was hurting me. 1 minute. That's it. Removed. Thank you. There we are. Much more casual now. Yes, never buy polyester. You'll be out somewhere and you'll wish you never. You really heat up. Especially don't buy polyester sheets. Oh, my God. You will sweat something chronic in bed. Pay a few, little bit extra, 100% cotton. Never, ever buy anything with polyester in it. Unless it's for the outside. You know, you've got something on out. You know, you've got like a coat or something like that. I suppose that's acceptable. But certainly not if it's next to your very, very delectable natural skin. Oh, I can see your skin from here. So smooth and beautiful. Why do you want to rough it up with nasty old polyester when you can have very, very natural cotton? There's my advice to you. Now, I said these were from Amazon. And funnily enough, there's a story. And we're doing a link here. We're like a Radio 2 link. 88 to 91 FM. This is Radio 2 from the BBC. Ba 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 ba. Boom, 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 boom. The news at 9 o'clock with Colin Berry. I wonder what happened. Is Colin Berry still on there, or did he retire? Don't know. Anyway, in the Daily Mail this morning, a news about Amazon. Yes. If, like me, I am a big, big fan... Is there another bit of cardboard here? Wait a minute. I'm a big, big fan of Amazon because it's so easy. You see what you want, you click a thing, and the next day or a couple of days later, it simply arrives in the post. No snotty stuff. Can I help you? None of that business. You're not pushed to buy anything that you don't want while you're in there. It's really, really good. And I've sent stuff back there before. No problem at all. The money is just refunded straight away. Fantastic service. But there is a dark side to Amazon. Yes, there's a dark side to Amazon, boys and girls. Amazon, this is in today's Daily Mail. Amazon, and you probably heard this before, actually. Amazon has been accused of dehumanising its staff. I mean, you don't get more dehumanised than me. Do you really think I look and act like a human? I didn't think so. Oh, no. Yes, its staff are battling, boys and girls, to deliver gifts to millions of customers in time for Christmas. Well, I should think so as well, lovey. Otherwise, we won't buy from them anymore, will we? It says workers at the internet shopping giant's distribution centre faces disciplinary action. If they lose a punishing race against the clock to track down items ordered by online shoppers. Well, I should hope so as well, dear. Is there like a management going around whipping them? With a cane or a strap of some sort. Oh, the slipper. That's it. Have I got this slipper? Oh, I have. Look at this. I could do the job. This is the perfect slipper for punishing those lazy Amazon staff for not working fast enough. Work faster. Faster. Come on. I'll tell you what, there's some bar staff in some places that need this. Oh, I shouldn't say that. There's one particular manager who I don't work for. I wish to add that. But I used to. He treats his bar staff like dirt. I've seen it with my own eyes. It's disgusting. He's a really disgusting, despicable man who absolutely treats his bar staff like dirt. Horrible, horrible person. But I mean, I do think I could work at Amazon. Come on, come on. They've ordered that. Come on, pick it up. Faster, faster. Yes, I can do this job. What are they complaining about, dear? Staff paint a picture of a stressful environment. Oh, I'm stressing. Ruled by the bleeps. Beep, beep. Beep, beep. Beep, beep. Of handheld devices. Nickname the gun. Instructing them on which items to collect. Well, I mean, how easy is that? I mean, it's easier than sitting here talking to you. Hours of preparation for this programme. There is hours and hours I sit here preparing this programme for your entertainment, boys and girls. You work at Amazon, they give you a little gun, you get a list of things to collect, that's it. Beep, beep, beep. I mean, how easy is that? How can people keep complaining, dear? Honestly. They face relentless time for targets on every task, with disciplinary action taken against those who could not keep up. Well, I mean, complaining again. Now, talking of time, I expect these people work, for example, 8 o'clock, perhaps till 8 o'clock, something like that. A small 12-hour shift like that. And at the other end at 8 o'clock, bang on 8 o'clock, they finish. Not like that with me. Look how hard I work. Look how hard I work for your entertainment, boys and girls. 20 minutes I'm supposed to do. And yet, when I go over time, I don't complain. I just carry on chatting. I carry on chatting because I feel I need to do that. I feel I need to do that for you. That is why I'm doing it. I don't want you to suffer. You know, if I see it go over 20 minutes, I'm only 20 minutes, I'm over time, I'm leaving. No, I'm not like that. I carry on regardless, boys and girls. You get your money's worth with me, I'm telling you that. Let's see what else they say. Workers face disciplinary action if they were deemed to have taken too long doing bathroom breaks. Well, I mean, how long do you take, dear? I mean, if it's taking a little bit longer than it should do, then you're clearly not eating enough fruit and vegetables. So it's your fault. It's your fault. Those poor bosses at Amazon sitting in their little offices, working hard with their pens and paper and tapping away on their keyboards to try and look after those lovely Amazon staff who pick all our bits and pieces. We can't have you spending half a day on the toilet, dear. I mean, where will it all end? Eat more fruit and vegetables if it's taken too long. Come on. Chop, 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 chop. Workers received £7.35 an hour. Just pennies more than the minimum wage. £7.35 an hour? Just a moment. And you're saying, hang on, it did say somewhere else, that they can do 12-hour shifts. So that's seven. I'm going to do mental arithmetic now. Seven, that's £73.50. That's 73, 74, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So that's 73, 84, 85, 89. That's £90. They get £90 a day, 12 hours. Well, that's not bad, is it, for a day's work, £90? That's what I get for doing that quiz. And look at the trouble I've getting to and from there in the car. Inching along slowly in the traffic, trying to get down the Euston Road, which is covered in the evil, evil Uber and minicab drivers that haven't got a clue where they're going. I have to suffer that, but I still get there. Stop complaining, these Amazon people, dear. It carries on. Staff have to work compulsory extra days and hours and were given short notice of shift changes. Well, you know, sometimes my mate rings me, oh, we're going out shortly, so I have to make sudden changes and I still come in and do this programme, darling. Dedication. Dedication. Ooh. Dedication. Ooh. Dedication. That's what you need. Which clearly some of these staff haven't got. It goes on. There was an atmosphere of mistrust and suspicion. with handheld scanners tracking workers' whereabouts, plus closed-circuit television cameras monitoring the warehouse and airport-style security checks. Well, here's my camera. What's the difference between working at Amazon and doing a show in here? Here is my camera here, watching everything I do. Yes, I can see you all watching there, waiting for me to do something wrong, aren't you? Yes, your evil eye is waiting, waiting for me to make a mistake. And then you're there, especially Joey. Joey's one of them. He's always there. Griff, you made a mistake. It was Shania yesterday, but that was unforgivable to forget to change the great Barry Manilow's photograph to the December one. Unforgivable. I am hoping at some point to receive a letter from Barry letting me off. Forgiving me for making that error of judgment. I'm surprised Virgin Media hasn't taken me offline. I really am, after that mistake. Unforgivable. It carries on. Staff were left with blistered feet after walking up to 14 miles a day. Well, that'll stop you getting fat then, won't it? And if you're moaning about your fat, buy some decent bloody trainers. Christ almighty, you must sell them in that place somewhere. Don't they sell cheap trainers in Amazon? Get some decent ones and you won't get blistery feet. Moan, 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 moan. Don't they moan a lot? Honestly, I thought my cat moaned enough downstairs. Yeah, until I saw this story about the Amazon staff. The Mail on Sunday went undercover. Undercover at one of the firm's fulfillment centres. Oh, if only I could feel fulfillment. I don't feel fulfillment. I really don't. Where has it gone now? At a place near Glasgow, one of the busiest times of the year. Taking a job as a picker. As a picker, one of the thousands of seasonal workers employed to collect the items from the shelves before they are sent to customers. We worked up to 11 and a half hours a day for 9 days at one of Amazon's huge workhouses. Warehouses. Well, you could call them workhouses, couldn't you? Good. Well, how lucky you are to have so many hours. A lot of people out there haven't got any jobs. It might be comforting to imagine the firm's premises are staffed by happy bands of Santa's elves. Oh, yes. But one worker told us it's about being bossed around by a scanner and having no thoughts beyond the next shelf number. Yeah, I can understand it. You have to leave your brains behind when you start working here. You're just a zombie. I am a zombie. Do they eat people? Zombies eat people, don't they? And the story goes on. But there we are. Very interesting look into the world of Amazon. I wouldn't want to work there, would you? How awful. On the other hand, you know, people have got jobs. So bit one another. I don't think I'd like to work there. I think, you know, when you've got staff underneath you, you need to treat them with respect. You absolutely do need to treat them with respect. And unfortunately, unfortunately, there are a lot of people above who have got people working underneath them who don't treat them well. And how can you honestly expect to get the best out of people if you don't treat them with a mark of respect? And I've seen this in so many places that I've worked. I left somewhere, not because of the way I was treated, but by the way I saw other people treated. I'll tell you where it was one day. I will tell you one day. But it was disgusting, absolutely despicable how this particular person used to talk to his staff. And they were all so young as well, you know, just dreadful. And who the bloody hell do you think you are to talk to people like that? You're just an ugly oaf, if you like that. Possibly like some of those people that are above people at Amazon, of course. I do think that. And if you work at Amazon, my heart goes out to you. But thank you for sending my parcels very, very quickly. All right? Message here. Good morning to Adam the plumber, who says, good morning, dear. Just to let you know, I am not technically, because we were talking about Adam the plumber the other day, weren't we? I said to you that he was taking a service the other day, and I thought he was classed as a minister. And while he was doing one of his readings, his teeth fell out. Because he's... Stop. Don't laugh. His teeth fell out. I can't make... These are all my own. Honestly. My dentist, Mo the dentist, who's from... Now, where I think he's from Latvia or Slovakia. One of those places. He's such a nice man. He really... Excuse me. He's such a nice man. He's very friendly and that. And very, very efficient. Do you know what I mean? He doesn't do any small talk. He asks how you are, if you've got any extra medical conditions or anything like that, and he starts his job. And he don't talk to you after that unless he needs to. Very, very good worker. Mo, I will give him a mention. That's Mo the dentist at the Bracknell, oh, what's it called? Bracknell, would you want me to find out, dear? Just a moment, Bracknell dentist, one moment, please. Bracknell... Crossways, that's it. Crossways Dental Surgery in Bracknell. Mo, the dentist, very, very pleased to have him operating on my teeth. There's one machine I don't like, and it's a descaler, electric descaler. And sometimes, because I've got some gaps in between the top of my teeth, my gums are receding. Because I've got a little condition, unfortunately, that makes that happen. And there is, like, you know, a bit there. And sometimes he hits something with that descaling thing, which hurts a bit. And he apologises quickly, so that's all right. Anyway, Adam says, I've got hiccups again. I'm not technically a minister at my church, but I am known as a chair. And no, you can't sit in me. If you're a chair, I think you should be sat on. I really do, Adam. It's simply run the service as it goes. So thank you for that, Adam, for correcting me there. Good evening. Welcome. Introducing the medium. Oh, hang on a minute. Adam, dear, please check your writing. You've split up the paragraphs and sentences there. I'm going to have to decipher this as I go. I like that word. There's your thing of the day to do, boys and girls. Use the word decipher. In a sentence, if you can, okay? So he says, I simply run the service, so it goes, good evening, welcome, introduced the medium. Sing the first song, into a period of silence to give out healing thoughts to those in need in the medium. Does the opening prayer that's followed by the Lord's Prayer, after which somebody comes up and doesn't reading from a book of interest. Okay, Adam, I'm sorry, Adam. You're going to have to rewrite that, darling. I can't work that out, what you're saying there, love. You've typed that either too quickly or you're using predictive text or something, and it's difficult to understand. Could you? Is it possible that you could type that again and check it before you send it to? I can't work out what you're saying there. It's like trying to decipher some of these karaoke requests that people write on a bit of paper. You can't read what it says, dear. What does it say? Please resend that, Adam. Thank you very much, dear. Now, there's another little email that dropped in my email letterbox from Mike Cullen. Hello, Mike. How are you? He does internet radio. I don't know what you're doing at the moment, Mike, actually. He says, Chris, I'm sorry I've missed your shows, but I've been catching up with them. As you might have seen on Facebook, you mentioned the Daily Mail's pictures and the drag queen song. Is there any chance of getting a copy of that song? Well, I've found your Facebook page and I've pasted the video onto your wall. OK, so hopefully that will help you there. And I think it's also available on the iTunes. All right. Let's do, one moment please, where is that now, let's do, Vectis, oh that was quick, just as it's coming there, Vectis apparently is 57 today, coming from a 63, oh no sorry, Vectis says 57 bloody cheek, well it's very unusual for you to swear Vectis, and in front of your lovely daughter and lovely son as well, Shania and Callum, I'm shocked. I'm shocked that you've used the word bloody underneath a video that I spent time making that video and wishing you happy birthday, and you've used the word bloody. I'm shocked and horrified, especially after just coming from church as well. I'm shocked and horrified, Vectis. So how old are you then? Come on, spill the beans. It was his birthday. Was it yesterday, I think it was? And what did you get? Oh, let's have a quick look to see what he got for his birthday. Yeah, Vectis. Oh, he's got a new hooded top. Yes, is that trousers as well? Picture's a little bit dark there, dear. Oh, what's that animal you've got there? Oh, he's got an animal in a cage. Just a minute, let me see if I can... Is it a rabbit? You're not... That's not for Christmas, that rabbit, is it? Please don't tell me you've got a rabbit. And that cage is... Oh, let the rabbit out of the cage, dear. I can't stand animals locked up in cages. Let cage is far too small. Poor little rabbit, dear. Oh, poor little rabbit. Now, what's that? He's got a bag on the wall. I'm just trying to see if it's a Waitrose carrier bag. I don't know what that is. It's got like green or blue. It looks like a bit of a Christmas tree upside down or something. Let's have a look in his house now. Oh, is that a dartboard on your wall there? I think he's got a dartboard. He's got a happy birthday thing just at the ceiling above the door. Ah, a Parker anorak. Oh, is that yours? Parker anorak. Oh, you are getting with the kids, aren't you? Oh, live young. That's what I say, Vectis. The carpet. He's got a patterned carpet, which is quite nice. And is that a gas fire? Because the corner of that gas fire, I have to tell you, Vectis, looks remarkably similar to mine. To my mum's, because I don't have a gas fire here, but when we lived in Roehampton, we had a gas fire. In fact, Vectis, that was the only heating we had when I was a child. When we moved to Roehampton in 1969, the only heating we had in that house was a gas fire in the living room. And I had this little fan heater thing. We had one fan heater, and Mum used to come into the living room. Come into my bedroom in the morning before I went to school and turned on the fan heater. But she weren't bothered by the cold. I mean, it was cold in houses then. Oh my God! You know, when I think I've got radiators in every room, I just push a button and the entire house heats up. They're on at the moment, actually. That's why I'm able to sit here and broadcast to you with my lovely red Paisley new shirt on, £33, from the very hardworking people at Amazon. Anyway, hope you had a nice birthday yesterday, Vectis. I also noted you doing an outside broadcast at a steam train place. My God, you must have been cut. Was that recently? It looks blooming cold there, dear. Was it? Were you cold sitting there with your little hat on? I should think you were. Anyway, let's do today's birthday. There's only one birthday today. Look at that, one birthday. Now, where is it now? Or there we are, Tina Rees. Let me just check you, Tina. Oh, that must be your little son, is it there? Tina Rees. I don't remember names. Oh, I haven't got a picture of you. There's no, hang on, is that a picture of you? Is that a picture of you doing, oh, hang on, profile pictures. That's all your little boy, isn't it? Another little person. Now, is that a boy? I mean, two little boys. Two little boys. There you are. Is that you there? With the glasses on and the blonde hair? Tina, is that you? I'm not sure. Oh, Tina, who are you, dear? I'm not sure who you are, but happy birthday anyway, my love. I'm trying to see if there's a picture of you. I don't know if that's you or not. Is that you, Tina? I like the glasses down the nose like that, like you're about to tell someone off. You could work at Amazon as well, Tina. Yes, tell them those lazy workers off for not wanting to pick up goods every 7 seconds. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Tina. Happy birthday to you. All right, have a lovely day, Tina. And that's it from me today, boys and girls. It's Sunday night, so we've got karaoke tonight. If you're in southeast London, in the Sydenham area, it's karaoke every Sunday. Now starts an hour later, 9 o'clock until 12 midnight. We had a nice busy night last week, okay? So do come and join us tonight. Karaoke Sunday night at the Golden Lion in Sydenham starts at 9 o'clock and finishes at 12 midnight. Have a lovely day. It's a bit cold. Very lovely and sunny out there. Clear, unbroken, cloudless sky. But very, very cold. See you soon. Cheerio.